Hello everyone, welcome back. Moving on towards the next part of the teeth selection in complete denture. In the last part, we have seen about the anterior teeth selection, and that too we have seen about the size of the anterior teeth. Now moving on towards the next two consideration for your anterior teeth selection, and also we are going to see about the posterior teeth selection. And in this video we are going to see most importantly about that dentogenic concept, which is a very commonly asked question that you should know in this teeth selection. So whenever you're selecting your anterior teeth, you have to see about the size that we have already seen in the last part of the video. So if you haven't watched it, I'm going to link that down in the description. And the next thing that you're going to see for your anterior teeth will be the form of your anterior teeth. And one more consideration for your anterior teeth will be color of your anterior teeth, because now your anterior teeth, it is playing the most important role of aesthetics. So because of that, you have to select your anterior teeth depending on these three factors. So moving on towards the next factor, that is the form. So the form and the outline of the anterior teeth, it can be determined using the following factors. So you have to see three factors in your form of your anterior teeth. First one is the shape of the patient's face, or it is the facial form. The next is you have to see the patient's profile, and the third is the most important, that is the dentogenic concept, that is nothing but the SPA factor. So first one is the form and the contour. Now in this, the shape of the artificial tooth, it should harmonize with the patient's facial form. So whenever you are selecting the anterior teeth, so that anterior or the artificial tooth, it should be like completely matching to the facial form of the patient. And this form and contour, it is given by Leon Williams. So in the last part also we have seen that there were various concepts. So one of the concept was given by the Leon Williams. So in that also he has considered about the form of the anterior teeth. Now this is undoubtedly the simplest and the most useful guide. In this, the shape of the upper incisor, it should have the shape of the face. Now how the shape of the face is, so depending on that only you're going to select your anterior teeth, that is your upper incisor. Now he classified the form of the human shape into three types. So there are three types of the facial form, that can be square, tapering and ovoid. So people have this various types of form, that can be some people having this square type of facial form, some may be having this tapering, that is the triangular form, and some are having this ovoid. So now depending on that, now you can see the form of the anterior teeth that you are selecting. The next factor is about the facial profile. So the facial profile, now we have seen already about the facial profile in orthodontics, that there are various types of facial profile that can be convex, concave and straight. Now depending on that, you're going to select your anterior teeth, that is the form of your anterior teeth. The next is the dentogenic concept and the dine aesthetics. So in this you have this three factor, that is the sex, personality, age, or it is known as SPA factor, because S, it stands for the gender of the patient, that is the sex. Then P, it stands for the personality, how is the personality of the patient, and the age. Now depending on this three factor, you're going to select your anterior teeth. So the dentogenic concept is the art and the practice, and it is the technique of creating the illusion of the natural teeth in the artificial denture. So in this concept is nothing but you're creating that illusion, like whatever the patient was having the natural teeth as, so you are going to create the same thing in the artificial denture also. And it is based on the three factor, that is the sex, personality and the age of the patient. And this was first described by Frisch and Fisher, and the term, that is the dine aesthetic, it is derived from the Greek word that is nothing but the dynamics, and that it means power. So it supports in the working factor of the dentogenic concept. So dentogenic concept is nothing but it is the concept which is creating that illusion of the natural teeth in your artificial dentures, and it has this three main factor, that is the sex, personality and the age. So first we are going to see how the gender of the patient, it will affect in the selection of your anterior teeth. So the first point in this will be, in females, the incisal angle, they are more rounded and the teeth, they have less angulations. While in males, the incisal angles, they are rounded to a lesser degree and the teeth, they are more rounded. So this is the difference, that in females, the incisal angle will be more rounded and the teeth will have less angulation, whereas in males, you'll see that the teeth, they are more rounded and the incisal angle angulation, it will be less when you're comparing it with the female. So this is the first point about the incisal angle. The next will be the incisal edge of the central incisor. It is parallel to the lips, and the laterals, they are above the occlusal plane in males. Now over here, this is the picture for your arrangement of the central and the lateral incisor. Now you will see that in this, the incisal edge of your central incisor, it is parallel to the lips. So you over here, you can see. So this is like the parallelism of your central incisor to the lips, and the lateral incisor, it is above the occlusal plane in males. But wherein is female, you'll see that it follows the curve of the lower lip. Now over here you can see, so the central incisor and the lateral incisor, it is following the curve of your lower lip. The next point is the distal surface of the central incisor, they are rotated posteriorly for females. So in this, the distal surface of your central incisor, it is rotated posteriorly. The next is the lateral incisor. So in this, the mesial surface, they are rotated anteriorly in relation to the central incisor in females. So in this, we have seen that the central incisor, they are rotated posteriorly on the distal surface, and in the lateral incisor, the mesial surface, they are rotated anteriorly. Now in this, the mesial ends, they are hidden by the central incisor. So this makes the canine very prominent in males. So this is the next point. Now about the canines will be, only the mesial third, they are visible in females because they are rotated anteriorly in relation to the central incisor, whereas even in the middle two-third of the canine, they are visible in males. So in this, now you can see over here. So in females, only the first part, that is the mesial third, is seen, whereas in males, the middle two-third is also seen for your canine. So this is about the various factors that you're going to consider, like what are the differences between the gender, like how you're going to consider in the anterior teeth. The next factor is about the age, like how age of the patient, it like affects the selection of the anterior teeth. Now in this, the age, it can be easily separated into young, middle or elderly. So in this, you'll see that in elderly, there is decrease in the muscle tone, there will be sagging of the cheeks and the lower lip. So because of that, what can happen is there can be cheek biting. So to prevent that cheek biting, what you can do is you are going to increase the horizontal overlap of the posterior teeth in elderly patients. The next will be the interocclusal distance. It reduces with the age. Hence, the mandibular incisor or the teeth, they are more visible than the maxillary teeth. In like, you'll see that the distance interocclusally, it is reducing with age. So because of that, the mandibular teeth, they are more visible in the elderly than the maxillary teeth. Now, the next point will be, in the old patients, the teeth, it tend to have square form due to atresia. Now, as there is atresia which is present in the older patients, so because of that, the teeth will have that squarish form. So because of that, you have to select the teeth that are having the square form. Because now, if you select the teeth which are having that ovoid shape, so it will not look good aesthetically. So because of that, in elderly patient, you have to select that square form to give that natural look. So more round features, they disappears, and the line angle, they're quite seen in those patients. So the old patient, they have gingival recession, and it can be reproduced in the dentures also. So these are like the various points that you can like show up in the dentures also that the old patient may have naturally. And the next will be, the color of the teeth, it also changes with age, as there is atresia, as your like enamel, it is abraded off. So because of that, there will be more yellowish color in the older patient. So because of that, the color of the teeth is also changed with the age of the patient. The next factor is about the personality in your dentogenic concept. So it seems reasonable that a large, vigorous type of person having a teeth of a size and a form with a prominent marking, which is different from those of a delicate appearing person. Now there will be like different type of people. So they are classified as the people, they can be vigorous or they may be delicate. So if the people, they are vigorous, so because of that, you have to give them more prominent features on your anterior teeth. And the people who are having like a delicate personality, so because of that, you have to give like anterior teeth in such a form that can match their personality. So because of that, you are giving the teeth which are larger in size, and they are more squarish to the people who are vigorous, like who are having the vigorous personality. And the anterior teeth, it should be flat for the executive people. So for the executive people, the teeth, it should be relatively smaller and it should be more symmetrical. So like this, you can see. So if the people, they are executive type, so because of that, you have to select the teeth which are smaller in size and which are more symmetrical. So this is the difference between the gender and the age of the patient, like how you're going to differentiate between the males and the females, and how you're going to differentiate between the younger people and the older people when you're selecting your anterior teeth. Now the next consideration for your anterior teeth, it will be the color. So we have seen about the size in the last video, and we have seen about the form in this part of the video. Now moving on towards the next and the last consideration for your anterior teeth, that is the shade or the color for your anterior teeth. Now a color, it has four qualities, that is the hue, saturation, brilliance and translucency. So depending on all these factors only, you are going to select the anterior teeth properly. Now which are the various factors for your shade selection? So the various factor can be, first can be the age. Now in this, the younger the patient, the lighter the color is preferred. So the color of the natural teeth, it darkens with the age. As I said, it can be because of the deposition of the secondary dentine, or it can be because of the wearing off of your enamel, and it can also be because of the staining. So because of that, the younger people, they have a lighter shade, whereas the older people, they have a darker shade. So depending on that only, you have to select your anterior teeth, the color of the anterior teeth. So if the patient is young, so you are going to select the teeth which are lighter in color. And if the patient is an older one, so you are going to select the teeth which are darker. The next will be the sex, that is the gender of the patient. Now the sex, it may also affect the color. So it seems that the females, they give in a brighter teeth than the males, because females, they are more concerned with the aesthetic. So because of that, you have to give females a more brighter set of teeth. The next will be the race, that is like the color of the face. It should harmonize with the color of the teeth. So what the color of the face is, so depending on that only you're going to select the color of the teeth. So the lighter teeth, they are suitable for lighter skin, while the darker teeth, they are suitable for the darker skin. Although the darker people with dark skin seem to have very light teeth, this is because of the contrast in the skin and the tooth color. So basically it's like the lighter teeth, they are given who are fair, whereas darker teeth, they are given for the people who have dark skin tone. So this is the next factor for the selection of your shade. The fourth factor is the patient's preference. Now in this, what you're going to do is you're going to show a patient with the complete shade guide. So there are different shade of the teeth which is available. So you're going to show the patient that shade guide, and then you're going to select the two tabs that are lightest and the darkest. And then you're going to hold them against the patient's lip, and you're going to ask them to point the one that they prefer. So that is nothing but the patient's preference, like what they want. So these are the various factors for the selection of the color of your anterior teeth. So that was all about the anterior teeth selection. Now these two are the materials which can be used in the teeth, that is your artificial teeth. So the teeth may be available as acrylic or porcelain. So this is a very commonly asked short answer question, you have to differentiate between the acrylic teeth and the porcelain teeth. So this is the difference between it. So I'm going to post this picture even on the Instagram page so that you can save it and you can learn it during your exams. Now moving on towards the posterior teeth selection. So the selection of the posterior teeth, it involves four factors, that is the shade, size, number and form. Now in this, shade is not of that importance as it is for your anterior teeth, because now posterior teeth, they are mainly doing the function of mastication, whereas aesthetic was the function which was done by the anterior teeth. So in this, the shade of your posterior teeth, it should harmonize with the shade of the anterior teeth. That means whichever the shade you're selecting for your anterior teeth, so the posterior teeth, it should have the same shade. So that is about the shade for your posterior teeth. Now the next is the size and the number of the posterior teeth, how should be the size of the posterior teeth, because now this is very important, because now over here the posterior teeth, they are doing the main function of mastication. So in this you have to select the size such that they are not too small, because now they cannot do the function with what actually is required, and it should not be too large also, because obviously it won't be comfortable to the patient. So in this, the size, it should be appropriate to the patient. Now in this, the posterior teeth, they must support the cheeks and the tongue, and they should function in harmony with the musculature, that is in the swallowing, speaking and mastication. So in this size, you are going to consider three factors, that is first will be your buccolingual dimension. So the dimension buccally and lingually, so that will be the first consideration for the size of the posterior teeth. Now in this, the buccolingual dimension of the artificial teeth, it should be less than that of the natural teeth. Why? To reduce the size of the occlusal table and the stresses which are transmitted to the underlying supporting structure. Now, as they are the denture, So because of that, what you need to do is you need to reduce the size of the occlusal table and you need to reduce the stresses which are transmitted to the underlying supporting structure, that is your gingiva. So because of that, what you're doing is you're going to reduce the size of your artificial teeth when you're comparing it with the natural teeth, that is the buccolingually. The next is the anterior-posterior dimension. So now you have seen about the buccolingual dimension. The next is the anterior-posterior dimension. So now how are you going to measure the anterior-posterior dimension for your posterior teeth? Now as you have set your anterior teeth, so now you have your canine. So you're going to measure the distance from the distal surface of the canine till the ascending arc of your mandible. So ascending arc of the mandible is nothing but it is slightly situated anterior to the retromolar pad. So that distance, it will be your anterior-posterior dimension. And after that, you're going to like place your teeth in this area, that will be your anterior-posterior dimension. The next factor for your size, it will be the vertical length. Now, the vertical length of the posterior teeth, it depends on the available interarch distance and the length of the anterior teeth. So, the length of the maxillary first premolar, it should be comparable to that of the maxillary canine to have that proper aesthetic effect. So this is the third factor, that is your vertical length. How should be the vertical length for your posterior teeth? So this depends on the distance which is present in your both the arches, and it also depends on the length of your anterior teeth. So whenever you're selecting your premolars, so it should have that length of your canine so that it is giving that proper aesthetic effect. Now the next point will be your form of the posterior teeth. So we have seen about the shape, about the size and the number. So the next and the last factor for your posterior teeth selection will be the form of the posterior teeth. Like how is the cusp angulation? So in this, the form of the occlusal surface of the posterior teeth, it can be classified depending on the cuspal inclination. That is nothing but the angulation of your cusp. So it can be anatomic form or it can be non-anatomic form. So anatomic form is nothing but it resembles the newly erupted normal teeth. So they provide the best aesthetic, they are the most commonly used type. So in this, the cusp, they have the angulation of like average of a 33 degree and it has the range of 20 to 45 degrees. So over here in this picture, now you can see, so the angulation or the inclination of your cusp, it is 33 degree on average and they are nothing but the anatomic form teeth. So now the anatomic teeth with 30 degree cuspal angulation, they are known as Plinkington-Turner teeth. So now over here, now you have seen, so the anatomic form, they are having this 33 degree. So if the cuspal angulation is 30 degree, so that teeth, they are known as Plinkington-Turner's teeth. The next is the semi-anatomical. Now anatomical, they were having the angulation of 33 degree. Now in the semi-anatomical, so they are known as modified cusp or a low cusp tip, because now over here the angulation, it is 10 to 20 degree. So the 10 degree semi-anatomic teeth, they are commonly known as the functional or anatoline teeth and they are more flexible to arrange than the anatomic teeth. So this is just the difference in the angulation. Anatomic teeth, they are having the angulation of 33 degree and they are having the most aesthetic form because the cusp, they are more like profound. So because of that, they are having that aesthetic form and they are the most commonly used one and they resemble your natural teeth. Now in this, as the cuspal angulation is reduced, so now the cusp, it will, or the teeth, they will appear more flatter, like they are a treated type of. So they are nothing but the semi-anatomical, which are having the angulation of 10 to 20 degree. Now the next will be your non-anatomic form. So they are known as cuspless or flat teeth. Now over here you can see the angulation is like less than 10 degrees. So because of that, they appear like they are not having the cusp or like the teeth which are attreated, that are the teeth which are flat. So they are nothing but the non-anatomic form. So they have the flat occlusal surface with shallow grooves and no cusp. So the selection of the suitable form of the posterior teeth, it depends on the individual's requirement. So the anatomic form of the posterior teeth, they are more commonly used for the patient who are having the normal ridge relation and the well-developed ridges. So if the ridges, they are normal, so in that case you're giving the patient the anatomic teeth. Now when are you going to give the non-anatomic form of the teeth, that are your flat or the cuspless teeth? So you're going to give the cuspless teeth or the flat teeth in the condition of the cross bite ridge relation. Now in this condition, the lower posterior teeth, they are in the buccal relation to your upper posterior. So basically it's like when the ridge relation is having the cross bite. So in that case, you're going to give this like cuspless or the non-anatomic form of teeth. The next will be the cases who are suffering from the temporomandibular joint like disturbances. So in that case, as if the cusp is more, so it will create more problem to the patient. So because of that, you're going to give this like flat teeth to such patient. The next will be the patient who are having the nervous or the hysterical patient, or the patient where the neuromuscular coordination it has been lost. And the fourth condition, it will be the patients who are having advanced ridge resorption. So in such cases, you are going to give this non-anatomic form of the posterior teeth. So this was all about the anterior and the posterior teeth selection. So this is all you need to write if you get a long answer question for your teeth selection. So first you have to just like enumerate in the chart form the anterior teeth selection and the posterior teeth selection, and after that you have to explain like each of them in detail if you want to score very good marks in this particular question. So that was all about it. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then please like, comment, share and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.